talking about graphs of rational functions. What's a rational number?
It's like
fraction.
Fractions.
Yeah.
Good, fractions. Okay, go ahead and hit enter, Sheeb. Okay, so this is when we're going to get into asymptotes, okay? This should also be a review from Algebra 2. So, what is an asymptote?
It's like the point at which like the graph tries to like, it won't like,
it just can't cross.
Right, good. Okay, so it's going to kind of be like these imaginary lines where the graph's not going to cross it. Okay, and it's going to shift our graph around. So, vertical asymptotes. Does anybody remember how we find a vertical asymptote?
Set
the denominator equal to zero. So I'm going to add this over here to our asymptote list. Okay, so vertical. Set denominator equal to zero. And solve for what?
X.
Solve for x. Okay? So go ahead and hit enter. Okay. If he'll let you. Okay, so the next one we're going to do also is going to be a horizontal asymptote. Okay, so a horizontal asymptote, does anybody remember how we do horizontal asymptotes?
If the numerator is bigger than the denominator, then it's zero, right?
Uh-huh.
And then if the denominator is bigger than the numerator, then it's undefined, or like there's not one. And then if it's the same like both times, you put the numerator over the denominator.
Okay. Good. So like in Algebra 2, what we learned was is if it was bottom heavy, meaning it looked like this, the horizontal asymptote was going to be y equals 0, okay? We learned that if it was top heavy, it was going to be none, okay? And if they were exactly the same, does anybody remember what we did? We took the coefficients, whatever were here, and it was y equals that, okay? That's going to kind of hold true. Another way to think of this, if it is as long as it is not top heavy, you can always divide everything by the highest power. Okay, go ahead and hit enter. Okay, this kind of basically goes through everything. There's two methods here. We're going to use the method where we divide by the highest power. And I'm going to show you that. I think it'll be easier to follow if we do an example. So go ahead and hit enter. Okay, so it wants us to determine the asymptotes. Okay, so the first thing I need to do, boys, pay attention, is find the vertical one. How do I find the vertical asymptote, Tristan?
What?
How do I find the vertical asymptote?
That's what we were just talking about, right?
Before the one that we were just talking about.
Oh, shoot. Give me a second. Oh, set the denominator equal to zero.
Set the denominator equal to zero. Which one of those over there is the denominator?
The denominator.
Okay. So x minus 2 equals 0. Then what do?
Subtract 2. Add 2.
Okay. So x equals 2 is my vertical asymptote. Okay, the next one that I need to do is horizontal. Now, if we use the method that we were told in Algebra 2, are these bottom heavy, top heavy, or are they equal?
They're equal.
They're equal. So what should the asymptote be?
3 over 1,
which would just be y equals 3. They show us another method, okay? We can divide everything by the highest power of the variable. What's the highest power on this variable?
One.
We can also do this. Y equals, we can divide everything by the highest power. Okay? And then we can can reduce. Okay, so these reduce, I'm left with 3 minus 1 over x all over 1 minus 2 over x. And it's like taking the limit. So like in calculus, we take the limit. And anytime we have x approaching infinity, so think about this. If I had 1 over 1, that equals 1, right? 1 over 2 is like 0.5. 1 over 3 is 0.333. 1 over 4 is 0.25. If I kept going and that number keeps getting bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger, where is this number going?
Down.
What's it approaching?
Negative
infinity. 0. 0. It's going to 0 because it can't ever go past 0, right? Because that would make it undefined in the denominator. Okay? So it's like saying all of these are going to 0. And I'm just left with 3 over 1, which is what we just said, right? Y equals 3. Okay? So there's
that
another.
Seems like way more complicated.
It is.
I'm not real sure why they choose to do it this way in this one. But yeah. All right, so go ahead and hit enter. Okay? Let's look at this next one. Says, alright, it says use the parent graph of 1 over x to graph each function. Describe the transformations that take place. Identify the new location of each asymptote. Okay, so on this next one, let's find our asymptotes. How do I find the vertical one?
You set the denominator equal to 0.
So x plus 5 equals 0, so x equals
negative 5.
Negative 5. Okay? Over here, you can see they have graphed. This is my x equals negative 5 asymptote. What does this graph look like originally? What did we know that it looked like, our parent graph? What did this one look like?
1 over x.
Yeah. What's that look like? Like the horseshoes.
Yeah.
Okay. And the only asymptote was at 0. Where is this going to shift my graph?
Left 5.
Left 5. Very good. Now we just need to know, is it going to move it up or down? So we need to find the horizontal asymptote. Okay. Are these top heavy, bottom heavy, or equal?
Bottom heavy.
So what did we say about a bottom heavy one?
It equals 0.
Yep, asymptote was going to be 0, which they have right here in red, y equals 0. So did it shift it up or down?
No.
No.
So the only shift did what?
Left 5.
So the vertical asymptote was the only shift that was different than the parent graph. Good. Okay, go ahead and hit enter. Okay, what about this one?
No, I didn't do it.
It's okay. Well, you can get the next one. Okay?
I did it.
All right. So, vertical. Okay. I need to set the what equals 0?
Denominator.
So, 2x equals 0. X equals?
0.
0. Okay. So, there's going to be an asymptote at 0. This is not the right. This is the one from the one before. Tristan.
We did it.
Okay, so now let's do the next one. Horizontal. Okay, is it top heavy, bottom heavy?
Bottom heavy.
Okay, so the what's the asymptote going to be?
Y equals 0.
Y equals 0. Oh, it's bottom. Heavy, yeah, it's 0.
If
it's top heavy, it's none. Okay?
He told me to.
Don't listen to him.
He told me
stop.
To.
I'm videoing this, so stop. Okay, hit enter. Alright, so let's look at these.
Okay.
Alright. So the first thing I need to do is the vertical asymptote. Can we look at this one by now and tell me what the vertical asymptote is?
3.
X equals 3. Good. What about the horizontal?
Y is zero.
Okay, good. So we can see that this went to the right three, and it didn't go up or down at all. What about this one? What's going to happen here? What's the vertical asymptote on this one?
-2.
X equals -2. Okay, and we can see it shifted it down 2. What about the horizontal asymptote?
Equals -4, I think.
This turns into what? This part of it turns into what?
Mm-hmm.
Or what for the horizontal asymptote? What does it turn into?
0.
Hey.
-4. So.
I was right.
-4.
Is that
good?
-4.
Which is why. It dropped it down to 4. Now, in this case, if we would have used the method that they're showing us, what is the highest power of x?
1.
Yes. So what I could have done was this. Okay. So this one is going to reduce to 1, this is going to 0, this one's going to go to 0, 0 over 1 minus 4, this becomes 0, minus 4 equals -4.
I'm looking at video of it.
Okay. That's another way to think about doing it their way. Okay, go ahead and hit enter. And enter again. I can't remember if this has more to it. Hit enter. Okay, so here is something that we did not get to in Algebra 2. Okay, so this part's going to be new. This one is when we're going to have a slant asymptote. Okay, so this is whenever it is top heavy.
I didn't do it.
Go over there now.
I wasn't.
Because one of you needs to move. There's too much talking. Okay. All right, so this one is top heavy, meaning that the highest power is located on top. So it's kind of like an improper fraction. And if I had, what is that equal to if I turned it into a mixed number?
5 1/3.
5 3 1 2/3.
Good. So you got that by dividing 3 into 5, right? And getting the remainder?
I thought that was 2.
Okay, so the same thing is going to hold true on these. What we're going to do is we're going to do long division. So go ahead and hit enter. Yes, so we're going to do long division. Now, does anybody remember what is the rule for when we can use synthetic division? Does anybody remember when I can use it and when I can't?
It's like x minus a number or x plus a number.
Yeah, as long as there's not a number out here and this is the power of 1, I can use synthetic division, which is going to be the easiest method. Okay, so what numbers go across here?
2, -3, -1.
Good. What number goes out here?
2.
2, good. So we bring down the 2, 2 times 2 is 4, we add these down, 4 minus 3 is 1, 2 times 1 is 2, and I've ended up with 3. This is my remainder. So this is the important part. I need to know how to write this as a depressed polynomial. How do I write this?
2x plus 1 plus 3 divided by x minus 2.
Good. Okay. The slant asymptote becomes everything before the remainder. This is my slant asymptote. And it's in y equals mx plus b form. Do you agree?
Yes.
Okay. So where do I start graphing that at?
One.
And what's my slope?
Up to
my graph is not going to be able to cross that line. What is the vertical asymptote? Now, remember we had, when we kind of touched on removable and non-removable, and if the top was factorable, sometimes we didn't end up having a asymptote because they ended up canceling. Do you think that's going to happen here? Do you think this is going to factor into something that where that will cancel?
It might be able to.
Are any of those going to be this?
No.
No. That's the only way that we could break that one up. Would it be negative and negative? Okay. So none of those are going to cancel. So we're going to have a vertical asymptote where?
-2.
All right. So that means our graph is going to be somewhere in between in this one. How would we figure out which ones it was
in?
I
thought it was a vertical.
It is, oh my word, I am sorry, thank you. Sorry. Alright, so let's try that again. I'm either going to have my graph here and here, or here and here. How would I figure out where it's going to be at? Anybody know? Without using the calculator.
You could plug it in.
Plug a point in. Yeah, so let's plug a point in for... Okay, so if I plug 4 in, or let's plug an easy one in, let's plug in 0. So that would be 0 minus 0 plus 1 over 0 minus 2, which leaves me with negative 1 half.
0 plus minus
okay.
0.
So where's the point 0, negative 1 half? It's here. So my graph will be in here somewhere. And if it's there, then it's going to be here. What do you guys think?
Okay.
If they asked you to graph it. Okay, go ahead and hit enter. Do we need to do another one?
No.
You good?
Mm-hmm.
Sure?
Mm-hmm.
Hit enter. And one more time.
There's nothing.
Go ahead and hit enter. Okay, so you're going to be working on page 187. All right.
So for like the